Now, this video is a little different. You may well have noticed there have been a slowdown in the output from the channel over the last few months, and there is a reason for that. Last year, I was diagnosed with prostate cancer, and a couple of weeks ago, I underwent a procedure called a robot-assisted laparoscopic radical prostatectomy, or RALP, the technology of which is probably worthy of a video subject in itself, but I digress. The operation was a success, and the prostate, along with the cancer, was removed without any complications, so hopefully, while I get tested, they shouldn't find any more. My backstory is something that probably 95% of my audience may want to take notice on. I had no symptoms other than my urine flow, or pee, had slowed down over the past 5 or so years, and getting started was getting equally slow. This was something which happens to a lot of men as we get older. My father had the same issue, and you may well have the same or know someone that does. I went to the doctors, had an examination, took a PSA test, that's the check for prostate-specific antigen, which increases with cancer, but also benign hyperplasia, which is the non-cancerous enlargement of a prostate, which again is very common, which they thought mine was. Roll on a few years and I do the same and get the same results. Then, of course, COVID comes along and virtually shuts down the entire national health system. So I opted to go private and have a HoLEP operation. That uses a laser to bore out the prostate, and even at that late stage, the consultant whom I saw didn't think that it was cancerous. So it came as somewhat of an unpleasant surprise, although I had been warned beforehand when the results came back from a part that had been removed, to find out that it contained 11% of an intermediate grade cancer, a Gleason grade 7, 3 plus 4, which means there was more very slow growing cancer and some slightly faster growing cancer. This put it near the bottom of the cancer grading scale, but still something that has to be dealt with sooner rather than later. MRI scans showed that it looked like it was still encapsulated and localized to two areas in the remainder of the prostate. Actually, being in the MRI machine was a bit of an experience itself, which you may well know of if you've ever been in one. There were a couple of options for treatment which best suited my situation: surgery to cut it out, or radiation treatment with an electron beam. I opted for surgery because if the radiation treatment wasn't successful, surgery would not have been an option because the remainder would have been too small to work on. But if the surgery wasn't successful, then you could still have radiation treatment afterwards. So there was a sort of double safety net there. It's now been just over 2 weeks after the operation and I'm getting on well. In fact, I was out of the hospital in just 30 hours after what is a major operation, which is common for this type of robot-assisted procedure, and you don't have a big cut, which takes a long time to heal. Instead, I have 6 small scars around here, the biggest of which is about 3 centimeters long, and the rest 1 to 2 centimeters where the robotic arms went in. I know it sounds scary, but the alternative, if you do nothing, is much more so. Now, I would like to give a big shout out to all those in the NHS staff at Southend Hospital in Essex, and in particular, Anna and Jim in the recovery room, as Jim recognised me from YouTube, and we had a long chat about all sorts of stuff as I waited to be moved into my room. So I would like to urge any men out there watching this that are aged 50 plus to get checked out, even if you have no symptoms. It's the most common cause of cancer in men, with 1 in 8 of us getting it. But if you catch it early, it is also one of the most treatable, with a survival rate of over 90% after 10 years. So that's my story, and I hope to be back to normal in the coming months. Now, as we've seen the news about the James Webb Space Telescope that is now fully deployed safely in its final position, I thought I'd close with a short piece from the Moody Blues from their 1968 album In Search of the Lost Chord, which I happened to chance upon a few days ago, but I thought was very apt in the circumstances. So I'll leave you with The Word, and I'll let you fill in the ending.
This garden universe vibrates complete. Some we get a sound so sweet. Vibrations reach on up to become light, and then through gamma out of sight. Between the eyes and ears they lie, the sounds of colour and the light of its eye. And to hear the sun, what a thing to believe, but it's all around if we could but perceive. To know ultraviolet, infrared and X-rays, beauty to find in so many ways. Two notes of the chord, that's our full scope. But to reach the chord is our life's hope. And to name the chord is important to some, so they give it a word, and the word is...